Hey guys, Kevpert here. Welcome to episode 3 of our 3v3 analysis series. Today, we're going to take a look at one of the best teams in the world in Northern Gaming, more commonly known as We Dem Girlz. So that's Remco, Maestro, and Greasy. They're playing against Genesis. This is game 1 of the RLCS LAN Grand Finals. I picked this match because We Dem Girlz showed how effective their rotational framework was. They have a very different style from everyone else. I think, in my opinion, it's a superior style, so we're going to take a look at them, see what we can learn. In the first two episodes, I talked a lot about the basic rotation and how, for the Flying Dutchman, it worked really well for them and explained all of their movement. Now, you can't explain We Dem Girlz rotation with the basic rotational framework. They just break from that all the time. Although it is the foundation that they build on, it doesn't explain most of their movement. Instead, they've created a unique rotational framework that I'll call the contested 50-50 rotational framework, which they use to create tremendous offensive pressure. So let's study this. We'll just start from the beginning, and we'll get into flycam here. And we'll just look at this from Blue's perspective, We Dem Girlz. So just off the kickoff, we're going to see the first instance of this right there. So instead of Maestro coming back and rotating into the back, we're going to see Maestro become the support player. So usually in these situations, Greasy, and I'm talking in a basic rotation, Greasy would be the second support player, Maestro would be rotating back. But Maestro is actually closer to the play. So what they do is Greasy will slow down, Maestro will become the second player. You see that? Greasy just taps the brakes there. And there's the free hit. And then you see them just get into a standard rotation there, or basic rotation. So Maestro's just going to cut in here. All right, doesn't work out. Maestro's going to come back. And this is just basic rotation. You see Greasy coming in behind. You see Remco thinking about going, but going back for boost. So here we see Remco, who had gone up for this hit. He's used all his boost here, right? He's gone up. Now he's going to flip all the way back. And I talked about this being a detriment to my team in episode 1. But for them, it's a huge part of their pulling off the rotational strategy or rotational framework. So what happens here is frequently what We Dem Girlz will do is in situations where a player has gone up for an aerial like Remco did there, they'll let that player come all the way back and they'll do kind of like a twos rotation between the other two players. And they'll try to get 50-50s upfield. This is more basic rotation, but you see Remco thinking about supporting there, letting Greasy go, and then getting the boost. Here you see the first real 50-50 opportunity. You see Greasy going for this. So Remco's reading this very early, and he's going to go in for this next hit. Now this is what I love about a 50-50, contested 50-50 strategy. Remco sees this as being contested 50-50. When it's contested, it usually gets pinged into the corner. Ball's generally stay in the corner or in the opponent's half. So by doing this, you can get very close and get the next hit. You see that right there. And it does not work just because Greasy kind of lands on the ball, unfortunately. You see Remco going in really close, getting the next hit. Maestro is doing a basic rotation and is getting in a support role off of Remco's hit. And then we would expect Greasy to come all the way back. This is just like episode 1, the basic rotation. Just like episode 2 when we talked about the Flying Dutchman. Okay, it doesn't work. And here we see Maestro go for a contested ball here. So Maestro steps in. You're going to see these guys grab boost and then support the play. Okay, so we see Greasy leave the field, the opponent's half completely and go back for boost. And at first, that doesn't make a lot of sense, right? You know, I talked about in episode 1, you know, going back for boost, you're so far away from play, you give up offensive pressure. In terms of We Dem Girlz, that doesn't really happen. This is what I'm talking about when I talk about their rotational framework. The player that hits the ball, Greasy, first, he's the first player, Remco's second player, and then Maestro's third player. So Greasy, who was first player, he's going to go all the way back. And he's going to go all the way back for boost. And Maestro, who is now second player in this play. So we have the aggressor, or the ball carrier, Maestro. We have Remco, who is now the closest player to be in a support role. And we have Greasy going all the way to the backfield. So what ends up happening is Remco will cut into the rotation. He's not going to go all the way back here and in behind Greasy. He's going to cut in because there's a lot of distance, and he's going to get a 50. And this 50 will let Greasy step. Now, Greasy's a little too far to be effective there, but this is just their rotation at play here. So we see the play slowed down. We see Maestro coming in behind, Greasy going for this. This is the basic rotation. This is the foundation of their play. But that just slows the play down, lets them get back. We would expect Maestro to get a clear here. He does. Maestro is going to carry this out. This is all basic rotation. And Greasy gets the clear. Just a little trade-off here with Remco. Remco's stuck in net. Remco decides against it, and Greasy goes. Okay. You see Maestro kind of hanging up here, and you'll see this a lot during this game, so kind of take note of that. What Maestro likes to do is he likes to be the support player by being up high, even past the ball. That's the common, you know, redirect position. So from Maestro's perspective, he only stays there for half a second, and he analyzes what's going to happen. So at this point, you know, he's already up there. He sees that this is uncontested. This is going to be a big win for his team. Greasy's going to get this. No one else is going to be close. So he stays up because he's confident in his teammate, Greasy, to get the pass towards him. All right. Now we see Maestro. He's going to fill in and become a support player for Greasy's hit. So Greasy's taking this all the way up. Maestro's a support player. We'll see Remco go for this boost, I believe. Yeah, we see Remco. There's the boost. He's going to go for it. Now he's going to just... He's not going to rush all the way up. Remember, Maestro is the second player, the support player. So Remco's just going to hold in the mid. So that's that basic rotational play. And then we see a little decision here. So I'll let this play through and then we can talk about it. But you see Remco thinking about going to the corner. He backs out. And then we see Greasy make a fantastic play. But... So Maestro's stood up field. You know, he stayed up because Greasy had a clean hit. He didn't have a contested hit. If he had a contested hit, he would have rotated back on the previous play. And then we see Maestro go for this. It's a 50-50. So Remco is going to try to be very close, and then Greasy is going to rotate all the way back. That doesn't happen, right? The play just kind of goes in the corner. It doesn't come out towards Remco. So Remco just backs out. But he does linger here a little too long, in my opinion. He should be coming back already. Greasy with the fantastic turn. You'll see this a lot. They are able to power slide, boost into the ball to get it clear. Now, all that does is just slow down the play because they're not really in good support positions. You can imagine if Remco had already gotten back here and Greasy had turned, then they would have been able to play out. Anyway, here we see them defending the corner. Now, this is something I talk about, I think, in the first and second episodes. You rarely see players defending corner. The basic rotation basically states that instead of defending the corner, if you're the furthest player back, you go from the goal, you go towards the goal, and then you attack the ball and then try to clear it out. What We Dem Girlz like to do is instead of letting it get into the corner and get centered, they're going to clear the ball before it gets in the corner or when it's in the corner. They're going to make a play on the ball and then clear it, so they don't allow other teams to get offensive pressure, especially in regards to the corners. Whereas you see We Dem Girlz use the corners a lot. So I think in this whole game, there might have been one, maybe two centers from Genesis. It's going to be pretty rare. And we see why that is in play, because they defend the corners very well. Basically, they're saying, we don't even want you getting close to our goal. We're going to defend it before it even gets into our corner. So we see Maestro here. He's going to turn. He's not going to rotate to net, as you know, my team would have done in episode one. But he's just going to turn, uses some power slide, and he's going to stop it. Remco is going to play off that. And then Maestro gets a clear. You see the offensive pressure that Genesis were trying to create completely evaporate. Due to how We Dem Girlz grab boost when they're in offensive rotation, you see Espeon going all the way back, not able to support the play. They're able to get a clear. Now We Dem Girlz is, and then... a little poor play there, but remember what I said about Maestro often hanging upfield. He will often make a decision based on what's happening with teammates and the ball. He'll figure out if he wants to stay upfield or if he needs to rotate back. Here, Greasy kind of lands in the corner, in the wall, so he's out of the play. Maestro really doesn't have a chance of getting this ball, especially with the onrushing Genesis players. So I know this happens very fast, but he kind of lingers a little too long. So as soon as he sees that, he should let Remco go, and he should be rotating swapping with Remco. But that's just a small thing. Not really trying to analyze their mistakes, because they don't have a lot. But this is kind of the drawback of lingering a little too long. And really, Quinn should have had a better hit there. You think about the little miscommunication between Remco and Maestro here. You know, if they swapped a little earlier, Remco could have gone. Remco ends up going very late. Quinn could have knocked this down towards Espeon. Maybe they could have gotten a goal. Or towards Pluto. Anyway, we'll see them step out as the offensive pressure from Genesis completely dissipates as they both miss here with Quinn's miss. So they'll carry out. You'll see right before Remco gets demoed, he's going to turn. So he's going to be the support player up here. He's going to become the furthest upfield, and then he's going to get into second man position, Greasy being the ball carrier, number one, and then Maestro being in the back, number three. He actually gets demoed, so Maestro is going to become the support player. And once he sees this, he's going to leave the play. He's going to give up on the play. I agree, because Remco is going to be so far back when he spawns. Greasy's kind of out of the play, so they're just going to grab boost and then go from there. Now, this is one of the classic plays of We Dem Girlz in terms of them being able to generate clears. You know, deep players will stay, whenever they give up possession, players will stay very deep. I know he spawned in the back, but we'll notice it in the future that they'll play very deep. If a player goes all the way back for boost, they'll generally stay in these kind of areas. And then they can clear a big clear of the opponent. And they're able to power slide, they're able to hit it off the wall, they're able to do all sorts of things to get a dangerous play off the wall or something. And they're able to generate a big clear. So here we see Remco get this hit. Remco is now the ball carrier. He's going to, I believe he's staying up. Maestro is going to go for this 50-50. Well, there's no 50-50. He's just going to go for an uncontested hit. But you see Greasy anticipating the next 50-50 and staying very close. So you see Greasy's positioning. There's the 50-50. Greasy's able to get the next hit. All right, and this is just pretty much basic rotation. You're going to see Maestro cut across the field, but you'll see Remco's really the support player. And he's reading the play. He reads the 50-50. Right here, he's looking at the play. Let's look at this from his perspective. And he's going to make a decision as to where he needs to be. So as soon as he sees that, he's already gone. And then he's gone up for that. It doesn't work, but they're going to generate a chance from this. Okay. Maestro with the hit. Maestro going to get boost, so now Remco needs to be a support player. He's going to get this next 50-50. All right, they both miss, and then Maestro with the basic rotation, just swinging in behind Remco, getting the next hit on goal. Now, that could have been a goal, but pretty good. And we see them just execute a basic rotation here. So you see Greasy in that corner. He's grabbed boost. This is part of the boost starve. Greasy's now going to step in, and Maestro, because he's rotated out in the path of the ball, he accidentally hits this towards his own half. So not that great, but this will get Maestro some boost. You'll see they're very comfortable power sliding. You'll see Maestro power slide and then try to generate a power clear. Remco gets it. But nice read there. As soon as they read that Quinn was going to win this ball uncontested, you see Remco and Maestro just drop out. And they're going to go towards the net. Now, this is a play we'll see twice. Once here, we'll see it later with Maestro. Greasy goes up for this, and you see Remco just kind of coming across on the front. He's not going to rotate in behind Maestro. They already have Maestro's keeper. You know, you don't want that redundancy there. That's really a waste of a player. This is, you know, their opinion on play. And so Greasy goes up for this, and Remco is going to get an attempt to get a redirect out of play. So he goes up for this, tries to get the second hit. He misses. But this is just interesting, interesting strategy to get out of play, get out of the back, pass it to another teammate, teammate gets another clear, you can hurdle a challenge and try to generate another clear from there. So Remco misses, but since Remco's closest to be the support player, because he's landed really well, he's going to be very close for this Maestro 50-50 with Espeon or Quinn. And then Remco's going to cut into the rotation to become the second man. Right, Greasy is going to see this, and Greasy is going to just hold. Right, and you see Greasy just swing back and become third man. Right, so there is that understanding. If you're going to cut into the rotation, that third player needs to hold. And you see Greasy do that very well. Alright, so Remco gets the 50-50 off of Maestro's 50-50. You see the positioning is very tight, very good. Okay, so Maestro understandably gives up on that play. And you see Greasy all the way back. He gets the next 50-50. And then we see this contested 50-50, you know, rotational framework at play here. So there's the contest. They're going to use the closest player available to go for this next ball. It's not going to be Maestro. It's going to be Remco, who's in a better support position. Remco is going to contest here. And then I would expect... Right. So Maestro's gone back for boost at this point. And this is also a signal to Remco that they need to keep the ball in the opponent's half to let their teammate go get boost. And you see Maestro get boost. And now, even though they get Genesis get that next clear off of the initial 50-50 here, we'll see that here. Maestro's going to be so far back because he's gotten boost that they can clear anything that gets cleared towards them. So you think about now they have a boost advantage because Maestro's able to get boost. They were able to get a 50-50, slow down the play. You know, they weren't able to keep pressure in the offensive half, but if it comes into the defensive half, they have a player so far back that they're able to power clear. And you see Maestro do a fantastic job of just power sliding and getting a big clear. Again, Remco not rotating all the way to the back and letting Greasy become the support player. In a basic rotation, a circular rotation, we would expect Greasy to become a support player falling in behind Maestro and Remco falling in behind Greasy. But Remco's already up, so they use their resources, they use the players that they have in these positions, and Remco is now going to become the player attacking the ball and getting the 50-50. Now, it's very obvious that he's going to get a 50-50 challenge, so you'll see Maestro get very close. The ball spills into the corner, and then Maestro has almost an opportunity to get a shot. So we see that here. Remco with a nice 50-50, but generates a clear. Now, very interesting to note, Greasy's positioning. He's just hanging in mid. This is the basic rotation, mid position, the third man position. And then he generates this hit off the double jump, which results in a goal. Nice positioning from Greasy. And you see Maestro here. He's just going to turn out because he's the closest player. And Remco had gone for that previous aerial, that 50-50 challenge. And you can see Remco already aiming to go all the way back. And you'll see Maestro just turn and try to attack this ball. That same contested 50-50 rotational strategy. It's Maestro who was the second player here on this hit. And this is their strategy here. Remco's number one, Maestro two, support player. Greasy number three, back or mid. And you'll see here, number three gets the ball. He becomes number one. But Maestro, who's number two, stays number two. Right? He's going to stay in this area as a support player. And Remco, who was number one, the ball aggressor, the ball carrier, he's going to go all the way back for boost. Okay, that's inconsequential, but that's what they're trying to do there. So that's how we can explain their play. So they do standard rotation, then they do their own unique framework, that contested 50-50 framework. It's basically a twos rotation, one and three swapping here. And getting the... right, one and three swapping, Greasy and Remco swapping, while Maestro stays in the same position. So that's all that is. Okay, moving on to the kickoff. So far it's 4-0. It's very dominant. Both grabbing boosts, a boost advantage. There Remco gets the third boost. And you see Remco just kind of, he's just cutting across the field. So off Greasy's hit, Remco's decided that he wants to be support player. I think he's going to end up backing out and letting Maestro get this. All right, this is a little communication between Maestro and Remco. And as it goes into the corner, this is Maestro's side. Remco is going to come out into the midfield. This is the basic rotation here. Pretty predictable movement. I don't think he was expecting Maestro to miss that. Kind of a weird bounce. And that's all right from Greasy. He's just slowing down the play. I know he's kind of facing the wrong way. And Remco's able to get back and get the save. Now, they're being very aggressive and trying to attack this corner, We Dem Girlz, and trying to get this out. They don't like to give up offensive pressure. So this is probably the only center you'll see in the whole game off the corner. But anyway, we'll see Maestro rush into the corner and try to get this clear. You'll see Greasy follow suit. You'll see Greasy's going to cut in front of Remco. That's totally fine. Remco's kind of out of the play. He got knocked. A little bit of a confusion between Remco and Greasy, who that support player should be. So Remco's just rotating out, and he's come back into the goal. Greasy misses that, and then Maestro able to get a clear. So let's see that again. A little bit of miscommunication, but they end up getting clear off Maestro. Pluto's facing the wrong way, not very dangerous. All right, so here we see a 50-50 opportunity. So it should be on Remco as the support player, the number two player, to make up this ground. As soon as he anticipates 50-50, he's going to get it really close and get the next hit. So we see that he doesn't go for boost. He actually goes for the dead ball off the 50-50. So very close positioning, gets in the next hit. All right, he's hit this into the corner. And we see that rotation. We see Greasy going all the way back. So let's try to explain this. So Remco, who is... At the time he gets his ball, he's the number one player, right? He's going to swap with Greasy. Greasy, who is the furthest up, he's going to go furthest back. You see Maestro is hanging in the mid and staying as the second player, the support player. All right, Greasy's out of the play here. He's going to leave. Maestro's going to hold in the mid. So this lets Greasy get boost. Maestro's thinking about going for this. You'll see him just kind of turn towards the ball and then realize it's not that great of an opportunity. So you'll see here, he's looking for it. Okay, it's not there. You'll see Greasy go for the boost here, and he's just going to power slide and then defend the corner, right? It doesn't make sense to defend the corner in a standard rotation, a basic rotation. It would have made more sense to go here, but this gives them the boost advantage, and it prevents going into defensive rotation, letting the other team get an offensive pressure. Unique, very effective if you can do it right. And these guys are probably the best at doing it. This is technically brilliant there. Generate such a powerful clear off the bounce. And get the boost, right? All right, here we see Maestro, who has stayed back. Not really happy with what Remco's doing here, but he's going to rotate. All right, he's not really doing anything in front of the play here. This is always Greasy's ball. So when Maestro goes in, off this to get a 50-50, you'll see Remco try to play off this 50-50. Now, maybe that's a little too high risk for me because Greasy's in the corner. But Remco, you can kind of see what they go for. In the contested 50-50, they try to get close. Remco's kind of facing the wrong way because he hadn't rotated out properly. Had he rotated out a little earlier, he would have been in a better position to get on Maestro's 50-50. Like, he's facing the wrong way. He's trying to turn. He turns the wrong way. This should have been a goal for Genesis. One of their only chances this game, but Genesis would be very disappointed at missing an open net. Okay, so let's go back. You see Maestro going all the way back for boost. Gonna make up some ground, get on this 50-50. All right, 50-50 doesn't work. But this part's interesting. This is now Maestro cutting across in front of Remco on the defense rotation. So what we can do to explain this is we'll go into Maestro's camera. And instead of rotating all the way back, he sees Remco kind of fall out of the play. He lands nicely, but he's on the wall. So he's going to fill in and become the support player off Greasy's hit and let Remco be the third player. So here you see the clear, and now they're out. Right? Instead of Maestro coming all the way back and filling in behind Remco, Maestro has more momentum, right? He has a better ability to become a support player, so he's going to cut into the rotation. Remco is going to stay. And there's that understanding. that Remco doesn't need to be going all the that far up to become the support player. Right, Remco's just going to hold. Now here, this is actually a mistake from We Dem Girlz, which Grizzy tries to rectify. This is them not understanding who needs to be the second player off Maestro's hit. Now they're both going for it. Grizzy realizes Remco's ahead, so Grizzy's going to tap the brakes and slow down. So let's just watch that. But Grizzy is going to be a little too far up to be an effective mid player. All right, Pluto generates a clear. Grizzy able to hit this, but he's going backwards. It's a tough one. Complete loss of pressure there. Now, with the deep positioning of Maestro, who's gone all the way back, he's able to just power slide and clear this back. This is standard rotation here. Right, Greasy's not going to cut in here. I'll try to let this play through. You see Remco going in. You see Grizzy falling in behind. And just the standard rotation gets them the goal, the basic rotation. But that ability to clear off the power slide is also very, very powerful. And Remco gets the goal. Basic rotation works for them as well. So we'll see Grizzy grab the boost there. Okay. Maestro's actually going to go all the way up there. I'm not too happy about that, but the ball ends up coming to his side. So instead of rotating all the way back for Maestro, if you're watching the Flying Dutchman, we would have seen Maestro, instead of turning here, we would have seen probably Jesse rotate all the way back to net. Right? Flying Dutchman, they rarely break from that basic rotation. Maestro turns here. They use the players in this area. Right? Maestro. They use their resources well, and he generates a 50-50 that creates a chance. So we see here, Maestro is going to hit this. Remco is going to become the support player, the second player off Maestro. Grizzy is going to stay back, although Grizzy gets bumped here. So at this point, the ball goes up. We see we should expect Maestro to leave here. He's going to go all the way back. And so since Maestro's gone all the way back, Remco's going to stay, right? This is that contested 50-50. There's a contest that Remco's going to get. So Maestro, number one player. Remco, number two, support. Grizzy, number three, mid. Try to remember that here. Okay, off this, number three becomes one, right? Grizzy, who was mid, is now the ball aggressor. Maestro's going to go all the way back. He was number one, the ball carrier on this side of the field. He's going to go all the way back. That means Remco, who was number two, the support player, he's going to be the support player again. So he's going to rotate. Just do a little circle here. And he gets this contested 50-50. Maestro reading that fantastically and rushes into the corner off this 50-50. He's very close. That works well because 50-50s usually result in like a slower hit or something. And Grizzy in a nice position to get that hit as the third man in the back. So he's going to grab that boost and stay in the mid. Gets a wonderful hit here. And then you see Remco leaving, Maestro spinning and staying as a second man. So instead of Maestro going all the way back in behind Remco, Maestro just stays. Remco comes all the way back. And then Maestro is able to get a goal here. So we see the last goal was from basic rotation. This goal's from their unique contested 50-50 strategy. So the contest happened probably around, I think it was here, right? Remco going for this contest. Maestro staying very close. And then they do kind of a twos rotation here. So essentially Maestro leaves here. Sorry, Remco leaves there. And then Maestro just spinning and staying as that second man. Instead of going all the way behind Remco, who had left the field basically. So they get the goal. Really nice. Just shows how versatile they are. You know, they're not so regimented. I don't know if that's the right word. But they're not so stuck in their ways that they always do basic rotation like Flying Dutchman does. And Flying Dutchman does that really well. But it becomes kind of limiting when they leave the ball. They don't attack the ball. They don't get 50-50s. And they constantly give up offensive pressure. Okay. So here we see Remco recover. And Remco's gone all the way back for boost. And then Grizzy gets that little pass back. And passes back are, they're really risky if you don't really know what you're doing. or if the players are in a basic rotation and they're very close together. But if a player is all the way back going to get boost, then you can easily just pass it back, Remco being in a nice position to just kind of back into this and flip. Maestro reading that very quickly and getting the 50-50. And then this is just that basic rotation at play there. You see Remco stepping across, and you see Greasy going to net. Nice basic rotation. Remco generating a huge clear. And you see Maestro here. He's kind of out of the play. But he's going to take that role as that support player. And Greasy, who understands the role of the mid player, the third player, so well, he's going to break here. He's going to slow down. And now he's in a great spot to get that next hit. Right, Maestro staying. And now he's the second player. You see Remco, who had left to get boost. So here's their framework at play. There's Greasy. Maestro staying as that second man. Right, Maestro was the second man here. Essentially, Remco and Greasy swap in terms of first and third player. Remco stays second player as that support player. Gets a 50. Keeps it in there. And by this time, Greasy's already back. And there's just no pressure from Genesis. Because Genesis clear. You know, you see Pluto here. I mean, they starved them a boost. Alright, Pluto's gone all the way out to grab boost. Puts it in poor position. There's no one attacking this next ball. And We Dem Girlz are able to get out. And we'll talk about what Maestro did here really well. This is that principle of using your resources, using players in these positions, rather than being stuck in your ways and doing the basic rotation all the time. So here we see Maestro's upfield. When Remco wins his ball, instead of Maestro coming all the way back, Maestro's going to stay with the play. Right, in a basic rotation, we expect Maestro to follow in behind, and we see Greasy following behind Remco, Maestro being the third man. But Maestro says, hey, you know, I'm in a good position to be the second player, the support player. I'm going to support Remco here. Greasy's going to hold. You see Maestro win the ball. Okay, it doesn't work out. And then Greasy making this insane read to get this play. But they get out because Maestro doesn't go and rotate back to net. He stays and supports the play and allows Greasy to be in the back. Now at this point, this is pure just reading of the play. You see Pluto's facing this way, towards the right wall here. And Greasy's gonna anticipate before he even hits it where it's gonna go. So he's hit it, it's in the net. I mean, this is such a good read. But there are some cues there. You can see Pluto kind of showing Greasy where he's gonna hit it. All right, there's a contested 50-50. You see Maestro's trying to close up that space and get very close for this next hit. Okay, it's a bit crazy. It's a bit crazy bounce, but Maestro's not going to go for that. He ends up backflipping. So we see Remco just doing that basic rotation. He's going to go right to net. You're going to see Greasy come all the way across, defend this corner. He's not going to let a center happen. Beautiful clear. Maestro going for a redirect. It's not really on. This is going to cause some issues in a sec. You'll see. So that's a poor decision there. Maestro, that's a very low percentage ball. And then you'll see here, he ends up trying to go for this boost here in the corner. There's five players in that tiny area. I understand there's 18 seconds, but this is good to analyze in terms of learning when to stay, when to stay back, when to go back. So by doing this, really Maestro should have just rotated here, because effectively at this point, Remco's the support player. He's following Greasy out here. Greasy's now number one. He's going to be the ball carrier, ball aggressor. Remco's support. Maestro is here. He's being like a double support player. That doesn't really make any sense. He should just be rotating back. Or if he's staying, Remco has to stay back. It's either one of the two. I understand it's 4-0. And so it's kind of fun to ball chase. But basically that pass, which is a brilliant pass from Remco, there's no one there to get on the end of that. So they get in a... They just give up a clear, basically. Again, Maestro defending the corner. That is completely fine. They don't want to give up that that center. And so we don't actually see Genesis actually get many centers. I think they hit the back wall like four times the whole game. and then one off a center off the corner. So that's game there. But we really see how effective We Dem Girlz can be. And we see them master both styles. You see the basic rotation at play here to get this goal, I believe. Right, Meister going for this. And then Remco being second player, Greasy not cutting in, being third player. And then that next goal, we see the complete opposite. We see Maestro stay as that second player, Remco going all the way back. And it's just that presence of mind of using the players at your disposal in these positions and using the closest player to get out. So we're definitely going to study more of We Dem Girlz in the future, frankly, because I think their style of play is superior. I know Greasy has moved onto Flipside and they've replaced it with Pashy, which I think is not going to do so well for Northern Gaming / We Dem Girlz, just because Pashy doesn't seem to be as good of a player as Greasy in terms of reading the play and really understanding what it means to be that third man. Pashy often kind of just chases the ball and tries to be a double support player. So interesting to see what's in store for We Dem Girlz. We have been trying to implement this style of play as well, which is very difficult. It requires a lot of reading of the play, good decision making, staying very close for 50s, etc. And then having good mechanical skills to power slide, turn, get power clears from the corners and stuff like that. So that's going to be it for this episode. Hope you guys learned something. As always, just leave a comment if you have any questions. I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. So have a good one, guys.